Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric, 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hi students, now from this class onwards, we are going to start autumn's chapter numericals, right? So the same chapter autumn's theory already completed. Now we start with the numericals, and now I started example problems, right? So after completion of the example problems, example numericals, we'll go for exercise numericals, okay? Right. So from this class onwards, we will concentrate on autumn's numericals, okay? Because in our previous class, already we completed wave optics numericals, and before that ray optics numericals completed, right? Now autumn's numericals, okay? Right. You know, here in that autumn's chapter, first Rutherford's atomic structure, okay? So based on that radius of the orbit, you know, the force, magnitude of the force, and right, the trajectory of alpha particle, and the orbit, electron orbits, we have problems, ma, basically, initially. Afterwards, I will tell you, okay? Right. So the first problem is, observe here, in the Rutherford's nuclear model of the atom, the nucleus is analogous to the sun, about which the electron move in orbit like Earth orbits around the sun. So he is comparing the atom, the nucleus and the electrons present in the atom to the solar system, that is what sun as a center, and orbits around the sun, okay, right. If the dimensions of the solar system had the same proportion, as those of the atom, would the earth be closer to or farther away from the sun than actually it is? So he is talking about the dimensions of the solar system. If the dimensions of the solar system had the same proportions as those of the atom, would the earth be closer to or farther away from the sun than actually it is? Okay, that is the question mark. And meanwhile, they have given some constant values, that is what radius of the earth's orbit, that is about 1.5 into 10 to the power of 11 meters, and radius of the sun is taken as 7 into 10 to the power of 8 meters, 7 into 10 to the power of 8 meters, okay? That is what I want to say here, right? So we'll go through the question once again, ma. You please be concentrated. In the Rutherford's nuclear model of the atom, the nucleus is analogous to the sun, about which the electron move in orbit like the earth orbits around the sun. Full stop. If the dimensions of the solar system had If the dimensions of the solar system had the same proportions as those of the autumn, would the earth be closer to or farther away from the sun than actually it is? Right? So meanwhile they have given some values. Those are, you know, radius of the nucleus, that is what, about 10 to the power of minus 15 meters, and you know, that is what orbital radius of electron, that is what, 10 to the power of minus 10 meters, and you know, radius of Earth's orbit, that is 1.5 into 10 to the power of 11 meters, and radius of the sun is taken as 7 into 10 to the power of 8 meters, right? So these are the values they have given. Now see here, now we are going for solution. I hope you conclude what is the question he is asking. The question is, see here, if the dimensions of the solar system had the same proportions as those of the atom, would the earth be closer to or farther away from the sun than actually it is now? That is the question. Okay, right, see here. The ratio of the radius of the electron's orbit to the radius of the nucleus, the ratio of the radius of the electron's orbit to the radius of the nucleus is 10 to the power of minus 10 meter divided by 10 to the power of minus 15 meter, right? It is what, generally 10 to the power of 5, okay? That is the radius of the electron's orbit, that is the radius of the electron's orbit is 10 to the power of 5 times 10 to the power of 5 times longer than the radius of nucleus, right? That is, the radius of the electron's orbit is 10 to the power of 5 times longer than the radius of the nucleus. 10 to the power of 5 times longer than the radius of the nucleus. Okay, right, full stop. Next, if the radius of the Earth's orbit around the Sun were 10 to the power of 5 times larger than the radius of the Sun, the radius of Earth's orbit would be, see this. So we have to multiply, that is 10 to the power of 5 with this value, that is 7 into 10 to the power of 8 meters, that is what, 7 into 10 to the power of 13 meters, right? So you please understand the logic to give the answer, right? That is what, you know, radius of electron's orbit is 10 to the power of 5 times longer than the radius of the nucleus. In that way, you extend this concept, you extend this idea to the solar system. So then what about the radius of the Earth's orbit? You know, radius of the electron's orbit is 10 to the power of 5 times longer than the radius of the nucleus. Similarly, if you extend that idea to the solar system, you know, the radius of the Earth's orbit around the Sun were 10 to the power of 5 times longer than the radius of the Sun. Right? Radius of the Sun, that is what the radius of the Earth's orbit would be. That is 10 to the power of 5 into 10 to the power of 5 into 7 into 10 to the power of 8. So what is that? 7 into 10 to the power of 13 meters. 7 into 10 to the power of 13 meters. Okay, right. This is more than 100 times greater than the actual orbital radius of Earth. This is more than 100 times greater than the actual orbital radius of Earth. Okay. So then what will happen generally? You know, when it is greater than the actual orbital radius of Earth, the Earth would be much farther away from Sun. So what it implies? It implies that an atom contains a much greater fraction of empty space than our solar system does. So if we compare the empty space in solar system and in an atom, right? And you know, atom contains a much greater fraction of empty space. Atom contains a much greater fraction of empty space than our solar system has. That is what it does. Okay, right. So this is all about the first problem, what he is asking, right? Next, second problem. See here now. See the second problem. In a Geiger-Marsden experiment, what is the distance of closest approach to the nucleus of a 7.7 million electron volt? 7.7 million electron volt alpha particle before it comes momentarily to rest and reverses its direction. Okay, right. I'll repeat once again. In a Geiger-Marsden experiment, what is the distance of closest approach to the nucleus of a 7.7 million electron volts alpha particle before it comes momentarily to rest and reverses its direction? So momentarily rest means what? So the velocity is zero. And reverses its direction. So finally, what he is asking? He is asking, what is the distance of closest approach? But they have given the situation. So what is the situation? Distance of closest approach to the nucleus of 7.7 million electron volt alpha particle before it comes momentarily to rest and reverses its direction. So it has to come, it has to stop, and it has to take the same path in which it came, in which it comes, right? That is, while going back, it has to follow the same path in what path it came, right? Okay. See here. See the solution here. You know, the key idea here is that throughout the scattering process, that is what all for a scattering process, okay? The key idea here is that throughout the scattering process, the total mechanical energy of the system consisting of an alpha particle and a gold nucleus is conserved. It is what law of conservation of energy. I'll repeat once again. The key idea here is that throughout the scattering process, that is what all for a scattering process, the total mechanical energy of the system consisting of an alpha particle and a gold nucleus is conserved. Okay, full stop. Now, the system's initial mechanical energy is EI. The system's initial mechanical energy is EI. Before the particle and nucleus interact, and it is equal to its mechanical energy EF, and it is equal to its mechanical energy EF when the alpha particle momentarily stops. I'll repeat once again, because every point is important. If you understood point by point, then when we are going for the ending of the problem, we understood clearly. Okay, that is what. See here. The system's initial mechanical energy is EI before the particle and the nucleus interact, and it is equal to its mechanical energy EF when the alpha particle momentarily stops. That is what law of conservation of energy. Right. The initial energy EI is just the kinetic energy K of the incoming alpha particle. But the final energy EF is the electric potential energy U of the system. See here, right? The electric potential energy U of the system. So if you compare this to the previous, that is what law of conservation of energy, then what can we write generally? You can write it as EI is equal to EF, because the initial kinetic energy, initial energy is equal to, You know, final kinetic energy, that is what EF, right? See this. The initial energy EI is just the kinetic energy of the incoming alpha particle. The final energy EF is just the electric potential energy, right? That is what? Electric potential energy U of the system, right? Okay. Then, you know, what is the potential energy U? What is the potential energy U, right? That you can calculate, that you can calculate by using this formula, that is what F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2E into ZE by R square. By using this formula, you can calculate. Okay, right. You know, we are going for next step, ma. Right, next, see here. Let D be the center to center distance between the alpha particle and the gold nucleus. Let small d be the center to center distance between the alpha particle and the gold nucleus, and the gold nucleus when the alpha particle is, when the alpha particle is at its stopping point. Let small d be the center to center distance between the alpha particle and the gold nucleus when the alpha particle is at its stopping point. At its stopping point. Okay? Right, full stop. Then we can write the conservation of energy. Then we can write the conservation of energy. That is what you know very well, ma. EI is equal to EF. EI is equal to EF. That is what you know, K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2E into ZE. That I have written directly, ma. That is what 2ZE square, right? 2E into ZE means 2ZE square divided by D. Divided by D. That is what here, you know, it is K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2ZE square by D. But we want to find D, no? That is what? Distance of closest approach, right? So, if you write D as a subject, you know, D is equal to 2ZE square by 4 pi epsilon naught K. D is equal to 2 square by 4 pi epsilon naught K, right? 2ZE square, that is what? Small d is equal to, small d is equal to 2ZE square by 4 pi epsilon naught K. So, see here, ma. The maximum kinetic energy found in alpha particles of natural origin is 7.7 million electron volt. That's already given as a part of question, right? And you know that if you convert into joules, it is 1.2 into 10 to the power of minus 12 joules. You know that the value of mega or million is what, 10 to the power of 6. And you know, 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joule, right? This is what, 1.2 into 10 to the power of minus 12 joules, okay? Right. Since, and this value also we know, that is constant value, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 9 into 10 to the power of 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square, okay? Right. And you know, therefore, okay, this value, that is electron, charge of electron also, we know that is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. Okay, right. We have D is equal to, that is what, 3.84 into 10 to the power of minus 16, 10 to the power of minus 16 ZM, right. Z is equal to 79, because the gold for the atomic number of foil material gold, Z is equal to 79, right? So instead of writing 79, he put ZM, okay? That is what. See here, and you know how this value came, means already we had formula here, right? So in this formula we have to substitute all the things. That is what 2 is okay as it is, and you know 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, in place of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, can write 9 into 10 to the power of 9, and you know here C square is there, sorry, E square is there, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 whole square. Z is as it is, because here we are writing in terms of Z now, so no need to substitute the value. That's it. Okay. And one more thing, there is a k also. K means in place of k, we have to write 1.2 into 10 to the power of minus 12 joules. By writing all these things in this equation, finally we will get it as small d is equal to 3.84 into 10 to the power of minus 6 Zm. Zm, okay, right. You know, Z value is 79 for gold, okay, right. And d, that is what, so that for Aram, that is what d. So that only he is saying, so whatever we are getting here, that only he is saying, that is what 3.0 into 10 to the power of minus 14 meters. So the distance of closest approach is 3.0 into 10 to the power of minus 14 meters. It is what 30 Fermi meter. 30 Fermi meter. Okay, right. And you see here, that is what the radius of gold nucleus is. The radius of gold nucleus is therefore less than 3.0 into 10 to the power of minus 14 meters, right? The radius of gold nucleus is therefore less than 3.0 into 10 to the power of minus 14 meters, okay, right? This is not in very good agreement with the observed result, right? This is not very good agreement with the observed result, as the actual radius of the gold nucleus is 6 Fermi meters. Fermi means, you know that, 10 to the power of minus 15. Okay? But here we got 30 Fermi meter, but actually it is 6 Fermi meter. So what is the reason? So the cause of discrepancy is that, the distance of closest approach is considerably larger than the sum of the radius of the gold nucleus and the alpha particle. The cause of discrepancy is that the distance of closest approach is considerably larger than the sum of the radius of gold nucleus and the alpha particle. Okay, right. You know, this is the reason the alpha particle reverses its motion without ever actually touching the gold nucleus, right? So this point I didn't write here, the last point, but I am saying. So whatever I have written here, that is what the cause of discrepancy is, that the distance of closest approach is considerably larger than the sum of the radius of the gold nucleus and alpha particle. Okay. So this is the reason the alpha particle reverses its motion without ever actually touching the gold nucleus. Okay, that is what. So in this question, that is what second question he is asking, right? He is asking what is the distance of closest approach, okay, and you know why it's going to reverse its direction, right? So we calculated by using this formula, that is what k is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 z e square by d. By using this formula, you know, we calculated, that is what, distance of closest approach, right? So that we got it as 30 Fermi meters, right? 30 into 10 to the power of minus 15. If you want, you can take it as 10 to the power of minus 15 meters. Okay. So this is what we did in second problem, right? Now see the third problem. It is found experimentally that 13.6 electron volt energy is required to separate a hydrogen atom into a proton and an electron. I'll repeat once again. It is found experimentally that 13.6 electron volt energy is required to separate a hydrogen atom into a proton and an electron. Okay, full stop. Compute the orbital radius means calculate the orbital radius and the velocity of the electron in a hydrogen atom. Compute the orbital radius and the velocity of the electron in a hydrogen atom. Two things we have to do. One is we have to calculate the orbital radius, and next thing is we have to calculate velocity of the electron in a hydrogen atom. In a hydrogen atom. Okay, right. See this. You know, here first, generally in physics problem, first we have to keep in mind what are the quantities they have given, right? Okay, see this. You know, what is the total energy of the electron in hydrogen atom? That is minus 13.6 electron volt. That if you convert into joules, just by writing in place of electron volt, if you write 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19, you know, the total energy of the electron in hydrogen atom, you will get it as minus 2.2 into 10 to the power of minus 18 joules. Minus 2.2 into 10 to the power of minus 18 joules. Okay, right. So what we have? That is, see here, orbital radius. Right? Okay, we are going to calculate orbital radius. Orbital radius R, this is the formula, minus E square by 8 pi epsilon naught into E. Okay? Right. And you substitute all the things, what they are asking. That is what E value is, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. And this is what you can write it as 1 by 2 into 4 pi epsilon naught, no? So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught means 9 into 10 to the power of 9. If you see that 2 is already there in the denominator. And this E value just now we calculated. That is what, in terms of joules we calculated. That is minus 2.2 into 10 to the power of minus 18 joules. Okay? Right. So from this, that is what, actually this is the formula for energy, but he is asking to find orbital radius now. That's why we have written orbital radius as a subject. That's it. Okay. So if you do this calculation, you will get it as 5.3 into 10 to the power of minus 11 meters. 5.3 into 10 to the power of minus 11 meters. Okay. Right. Afterwards, he is asking to find velocity of revolving electron. Right. So the velocity of the revolving electron. Here the formula will be like this, that is E by square root of 4 pi epsilon naught small m into small r. You know what is the mass? That is 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg, right? So by substituting that value and this whatever we found, that is what orbital radius, okay? So finally we will get it as 2.2 into 10 to the power of 6. 2.2 into 10 to the power of 6 meter per second. 2.2 into 10 to the power of 6 meter per second. That is the velocity of the revolving electron. Okay. 2.2 into 10 to the power of 6 meter per second. Okay, right. So in this class we focused on three problems, right? So in the first problem we discussed about comparison between the atomic structure, atom and nucleus, electrons to the solar system, right? So there we discussed the first problem, and in the second problem we calculated distance of closest approach in case of alpha particle and gold nucleus, and in third problem we calculated the orbital radius and velocity of revolving electron. Okay, so these three problems we have to focus one by one. Finally you will get it as how to compare the solar system with the atomic structure of atom and nucleus. That is, afterwards you know how to calculate the distance of closest approach. At last, what are the formulas? This is a pure mathematical, so what are the formulas for orbital radius and velocity of the revolving electron, and what are the values according to the given values. Okay, right. Thank you. We'll continue in the next class.